Well, it looks like Queensland's wild weather is on its way south. And to tell us what we can expect, we're joined by Jonathan Howe from the Bureau of Meteorology. Jonathan, it's good to see you again. Did the Lismore floodwaters rise further than expected?
Yeah, good morning, Sarah and Tristan. So for Lismore overnight, the Wilson's River did peak at around 14 metres, just over. Thankfully, though, it has started to now subside, but it is sort of sitting around that 12-metre mark, so it is extremely high, and it's likely to remain that way for the next few days. So the message to residents of Lismore is that the danger isn't over just yet, with the Wilson's River continuing to be very high.
Yeah. Jonathan, so there's more rain predicted around the New South Wales, Northern Rivers and southeastern Queensland?
Yeah, that's exactly right. So today, we are seeing a bit of sunshine and dry conditions with just a few showers today and tomorrow. But on Thursday and Friday, we do see a return of rain and thunderstorms right across northeast New South Wales and southeast Queensland. At this stage, it is difficult to say how much rainfall will come. It will depend on how those storms and rains develop. But we are expecting potentially another 50 to 100 millimetres each day on Thursday and Friday. So again, the danger isn't over just yet. We could see further river rises later in the week, unfortunately.
Yeah, there are lots of rivers that are now on flood alert. Can you take us through them, Jonathan?
Yeah, absolutely. So, of course, we do have quite a few warnings across both states, including the Brisbane River, which is expected to peak again this afternoon at quite a high level, but then start to subside. But other centres, including Gympie, Maryborough in Queensland, the Clarence River and the Tweed River as well, all remaining very high. So, again, just to keep an eye on those flood watches and warnings as we head through the next few days, especially with that rain coming up.
Storms and high winds, they're predicted to hit Sydney and the New South Wales coast today. Where and when will that be and how severe will they be?
Yeah, so this system is making its way down the New South Wales coast, and people in Sydney and the Central Coast are already seeing heavy showers through this morning, and we have issued a severe weather warning for communities all the way south of Newcastle. So that includes Sydney, Wollongong, all the way to the south coast, as is east coast low. Forms off the coast tonight and into tomorrow, so expecting heavy rainfall with localised flash flooding, damaging to destructive winds and very dangerous sea conditions as well. So these are very intense weather systems that can bring quite a bit of damage, and a lot of the soils across New South Wales are now sodden. And so we could see flash and flooding, including around the Parramatta River, the Cooks River and up in the Nepean Rivers as well. So residents right across New South Wales, pay attention to those warnings and follow all advice from emergency services.
And there's an entirely different weather event happening as well over Adelaide that happened overnight. We saw storms there. Is that event over?
Yeah, so we did see plenty of storms, not just across the Adelaide Metro with flash flooding, but storms for parts of Tasmania, southern New South Wales and Victoria as well. And that humid air mass will be around again today. So Melbourne, Adelaide, Canberra and even Hobart will see showers and possible thunderstorms, but there is a risk of severe thunderstorms, especially across central and western Victoria and again around parts of South Australia. So we could see these kind of storms lasting until kind of tomorrow and then not really clearing up until Thursday.
Great. Jonathan Howe, BOM, thanks so much for joining us today. Appreciate it.
Thank you.